The functional assessment-based intervention model employs a systematic approach to designing, implementing, and evaluating functional assessment-based procedures developed by Umbright, Farrow, Leopsen, and Lane, 2007. School site teams, including general and special education teachers, as well as other experts, such as school psychologists and behavior specialists, work together to complete this five-step process. We strongly encourage this team to include the main teacher who will be putting the intervention in place. This video introduces you to step one, identifying students who need a FABI. In step one, teams identify students through school-wide data, such as academic and behavior screening tools, office discipline referrals, and attendance records to determine which students may benefit from tertiary, also known as Tier 3, supports. These students may not have responded to primary, Tier 1, or secondary, Tier 2 efforts, or may have been identified directly for a FABI in situations where students demonstrate pronounced concerns and/or are exposed to multiple risk factors. Education records are often examined to look for patterns of behavior, duration of difficulties, and any potential interventions that may have previously been implemented. The referral checklist, Functional Assessment-Based Interventions, is a brief tool to document what school-wide data were used to recommend a functional assessment-based intervention and a place to document a brief description of concern. A functional assessment-based intervention may be warranted if the student's behavior impedes his or her learning or the learning of others, or poses a threat to him or herself or others, the student's been non-responsive to other intervention efforts, the student has multiple risk factors, such as screened as high risk on a systematic screener for behavior, or high mobility, making him or her more susceptible to school failure and/or other dangerous behavior. The student has been A, placed in an alternative setting for behavior dangerous to him or herself or others, B, placed in an alternative setting for 45 days due to drug or weapon violations, or C, has the student been suspended from school for more than 10 days, or has the suspension resulted in a change in placement? If you answered yes to the latter, a FABI is mandated by the Individuals with Disabilities Education Act, IDEA, 2004. For this step, it is also important to follow district procedures as well as federal, state, and local laws for obtaining necessary permissions. In subsequent videos, you will be introduced to the remaining steps of this systematic five-step process. In step two, conducting the functional assessment, you will learn about the functional assessment process where we discover reasons why challenging behaviors occur, the function. From there, teams progress to step three, collecting baseline data, which will focus on behavior measurement recording and baseline procedures for how we will measure present levels before introducing the intervention. In step four, designing the intervention, we will introduce you to the function-based intervention decision model, where we will learn how to pick an appropriate method, including antecedent adjustments, shifts in reinforcement contingencies, and extinction components. Finally, in step five, testing the intervention, we will discuss how single case designs with social validity and treatment integrity can be used to monitor and evaluate the effectiveness of the intervention. To learn more about this process, you may watch our video on behavioral data collection. You may also review Applied Behavior Analysis, 2nd edition, by Cooper, Heron, and Heward, 2007, and Functional Behavior Assessment and Function-Based Intervention, an Effective Practical Approach, by Umbright, Farrow, Leopsen, and Lane, 2007.